Welcome to Millennium TV News. This is Fozia, the one with today's top stories. Iran nuclear deal, 99% of world agrees, says Obama. Greek bailout, PM says UK won't provide interim funding. France explosions, devices found near belligerent Eton plant. Islamic State claims Iraq suicide car bombing ahead of Eid. British PM David Cameron says Eid Mubarak to Muslims. Now the details. He challenged critics of Tuesday's deal to present a better alternative scene as a valid reference to his Republican opponents in Congress. The UN Security Council will vote next week on a resolution endorsing the agreement, Iran says. In return for an end to sanctions, Iran will limit its nuclear activities. The president has said there will be a robust debate with Congress. His Republican rivals, who hope to scupper the agreement in a subsequent vote, have accused him of abstinence. But Mr. Obama said if 99% of the world community and the majority of nuclear experts look at this thing and they say this will prevent Iran from getting a nuclear bomb, and you are arguing either that it does not or that even it does, it's temporary, then you should have some alternative. Iran's President Hassan Rouhani said the agreement proved that constructive agreement works. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu meanwhile denounced what he called a stunning historic mistake. Tory MPs are angry that the UK may have to guarantee short-term loans to Greece through an EU-wide fund despite not being a member of the single currency. Speaking in the Commons, the PM said he had sympathy for Greece, but it was not for the UK to bail it out. EU officials said it was seeking a mutually acceptable solution. The BBC's deputy political editor James Lennon said the UK would resist very hard any attempt to get it to contribute interim support to Greece over the coming days and weeks through the European Financial Stability Mechanism. While the UK may have to concede the fund's use, he said talks were underway about ensuring the British taxpayer was protected and the UK ring-fenced from any liabilities. Conservative MPs have warned the financial decision may be made by EU states under qualified majority voting, so the UK could be outvoted. EU officials have said the Commission has the legal right to use the fund for 12 billion euros in short-term loans, which could be given to Greece as part of the wider 86 billion rescue package agreed on Sunday. The legislation includes tax rises and increase in the retirement age. 229 lawmakers voted yes, 64 voted no, and 6 abstained. Half of the no votes came from the governing Syriza party. Ahead of the vote, protesters threw petrol bombs at police during an anti-austerity protest close to parliament, and police responded with tear gas. Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras had said he did not believe in the deal, but nonetheless urged MPs to improve the measures. Alexis Tsipras said Greek people understood it was better to fight in an unfair fight than hand in your weapons. Speaker Zio Konstantopoulos said it was a very black day for democracy. He said he was willing to implement the irrational proposals to avoid the collapse of the banks and disaster for Greece. The vote passed despite 32 of his willing left-wing Syriza party voting no and 6 more abstaining. Among the no votes was Parliamentary Speaker Zio Konstantopoulos, who walked out during the debate before returning to make a farewell speech condemning a very black day for democracy in Europe. The blast went off at the Berry Alley tank almost simultaneously 500 m apart. Interior Minister Berend Sesnivu said it was a criminal act, but the motive was unknown. The local prosecutor said nothing had been ruled out, including terrorism. Asked about the fires, President Francisco Holland on a visit to nearby Mosul, said a statement would be made on Thursday. The authorities said this week also prevented terrorist attacks that could have taken place, he said. French reporters earlier linked the explosions at Berri Ali Tank to a moisturized theft of explosive and detonators last week at a military site in Miram's little more than 20 km away. The explosions were heard at around 3 on Tuesday, setting alight two tanks at a site run by Leonel Basel, a multinational company with headquarters in the US and the Netherlands. One tank was filled with petrol and the other with naphtha, a highly flammable diesel liquid distilled from petroleum. Former US President George Bush celebrated his 90th birthday last year with a skydive. Former US President George Bush has been admitted to hospital after breaking a bone in his neck in a fall at his home in Maine. His spokesman said he was in a stable condition and his hospital stay was expected to be brief. Mr. Bush, who has Parkinson's disease and cannot use his legs, celebrated his 90th birthday last year with a skydive. He had to go to hospital at the end of last year with shortness of breath. Spokesman Jim McGrath said Mr. Bush, the oldest of the four living former U.S. presidents, would need to wear a neck brace following his fall on Wednesday morning in Camp Port. Viewers, we all take a short lights here. Raul Castro calls for a new Cuba-U.S. relationship. Casablanca mosque temple blamed on mouse. BNP-led alliance incapable of launching evacuations, says Prime Minister Hasina. In a speech to the National Assembly, Mr. Castro said that for normal relations to resume, a U.S. embargo on Cuba would have to be lifted. He also called for the U.S. naval base at Guantanamo Bay to be returned to Cuba. On Monday, both countries are set to re-establish diplomatic ties for the first time since 1959. We are talking about forging a new kind of relationship between both states, different from our entire common history, President Castro told the Cuban National Assembly. He acknowledged President Obama's efforts to try to get a debate going on the embargo despite the fact that it was up to the U.S. Congress to vote on the matter. U.S. officials have said several times that Guantanamo Bay is not on the agenda for discussion with Cuba. The U.S. and Cuba began secret negotiations on restoring ties 2 years ago. This led to a historic announcement on 17 December last year where President Castro and President Obama said they had swept prisoners and would seek to normalize relations. On Monday, both countries are said to reopen embassies in each other's capitals as a first normal step towards re-establishing relations. The mouse is blamed for causing panic among ore shippers. A mouse is responsible for triggering us dumped in a mosque in the Moroccan city of Casablanca, which left more than 80 people injured, officials say. The rush happened in the city's Hassan II Mosque, which was full of worshippers on Monday evening. It was the holiest night of the Muslim fasting month of Ramadan, the Moroccan news agency reported. It quoted officials as saying that the injured were mostly women who suffered light injuries and fractures. All shippers were reported to have fainted after a mouse crossed over a woman's foot while she was praying, causing her to rush outside and creating panic among all shippers. Morocco World News reported, the Hassan II Mosque is believed to be the largest in Africa and the seventh largest in the world. Its minaret is 210 m high. The blast brought down several buildings in Khan Banisad, about 30 kilometers northeast of Baghdad, crashing to death people who were celebrating the end of the Muslim fasting month of Ramadan. Islamic State, which controls large parts of northern and western Iraq, claimed responsibility for the attack in the mixed eastern province of Diyala, where Khan Banisad is located, and said the target was rejectionist, as the group refers of Sunni Muslims. Angry crowds went on the rampage after the explosion, shattering the windows of cars parked in the street in grief and anger. Body parts were flung onto the roofs of nearby buildings by the force of the blast, police said. Some people were using vegetable boxes to collect children's body parts, said Police Major Ahmed Al-Tamimi from the site of the explosion, describing the damage to the market as devastating. Iraqi officials declared victory over Islamic State in Dala earlier this year after security forces and city parliamentarians drove them out of towns and villages there. Security forces and militia groups are currently focused on the western province of Anbar, where they have been gearing up for an offensive to retake the mainly Sunni governorate, Iraq's largest. The United Nations said earlier this week that nearly 15,000 people had been killed in the 16-month period up to April 30. Bangladesh's Muslims will celebrate the day after a month-long fast on Saturday. Cameroon urged families and friends who come together to celebrate the festival to think about the better Britain and world we must build together this Ramadan. "We have seen the very best of British Muslim values," he said. "We have seen unprecedented charity zakat with thousands upon thousands of pounds raised for the needy." He said Britain had also seen community spirit with inventive ways of breaking the fast with people of all faiths. He wished all a happy and peaceful Eid Mubarak. The Prime Minister, however, recalled the sufferings of Muslims in Syria and Iraq during the Ramadan at the hands of ISIL and Assad. He also recalled the victims of terrorism at Koban, Quet Mosque, and on the Tunisia beach. "This terrorism is not just an assault on those victims. It's not just an assault of Islam, whose good name it perverts. It's an assault on us all, on our way of life, and we must defeat it," he said. She asked the people to pray for Bangladesh's success while criticizing the BNP-headed coalition for its violent aggressions. "There can be no worse offense than burning people to death," she said, referring to the arson deaths during the BNP's demonstration earlier this year. Khaleda Zia did just that along with the BNP Jamaat coalition, she said after exchanging greetings with people on the Eid day at the Garda Bhavan. She said, "This year Eid was more joyous for the people thanks to economic development, hassle-free travel and tight security measures. No one will be able to harm Bangladesh anymore," the Prime Minister asserted. "I can say as much that they will never have the strength to do so." Earlier in the day, Khaleda threatened fresh anti-government aggression after revamping her party. She said the demonstration would be peaceful. Prime Minister Hasina sought her people's blessing to acquire the pace of development so that Bangladesh can attain a respectable position in the world, so that Bengali nation can stand in the global arena with dignity. The Awami League chief said it was evident that good intention leads to good results. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Millennium TV News. This is Fosia, the one with today's top stories. Iran nuclear deal, 99% of world agrees, says Obama. Greek bailout, PM says UK won't provide interim funding. France explosions, devices found near Bellator and Eton plant. Islamic State claims Iraq suicide car bombing ahead of Eid. British PM David Cameron says Eid Mubarak to Muslims.